Choosing notes, opportune things, and the contour we play, melody, which contour we have, and the rhythm we are using. This is an art, and this, of course, again, improvisation doesn't happen in ignorance, but in knowledge, in a lot of knowledge, actually. That's why people fear this thing, not just music, but in this style of flamenco. Because, as Paco said, this even helped him. So what to speak of us? He's saying everyone should learn. This is the goal, actually, where we should go, because there your identity will come out. When you flow, when you can flow with things and create it spontaneously, imagine how cool is this thing. So I myself keep practicing this thing, as per his advice, for more than 20 years. And of course, every day you discover something new, because there is two aspects. One is the practice aspect, and the other is the playing aspect. When you play, you're not practicing. When you practice, you address things that you don't control yet. And then, therefore, this has to be done under guidance and with proper supervision. Otherwise, we don't advance 1 centimeter, maybe rowing all night there in the boat. But if the anchor is there, then you, man, what is this? I want all night rowing at top speed, but I have not moved 1 meter because the anchor is there. So this anchor is all these misunderstandings. Of course, the do-it-yourself philosophy, do-it-yourself and be confused forever, is the main one that makes this main and most invisible anchor there, because you have to notice there is an anchor. If you don't even know there is an anchor, this thing we cannot learn by just watching videos. It's not possible, because one thing is what we will do and the other thing is you doing it. That's another thing. When it comes to you do it, then we have to know how you will do it. And to do that, that's why I have this course in the Skype. Everybody's welcome to join, and this is not an advanced topic or anything. From the scratch, you can learn it. But it has to be under proper guidance, and also you will see how the results are there, because you record your homeworks in listed videos, and then you will notice that these melodies at the beginning, we do out of 5 melodies, let's say, 1 is good and 4 not so good. Then the next week or next day, probably 2 melodies were cool, and then 3 are not so good. Then 3 are very good, and then 2 not so good. So forth, so on, and so in a way that you can, so forth and so on, I mean, in a way that you can get to the point that you play 6 great things out of 5. So this is possible in any level, and of course for that we need also some technique, but not the technique is the all in all in this, because also beginners do, I have beginners doing these practices also. It is important, even if you don't have a great technique, to start doing this improvisation thing properly, because this is your own expression, and here is finally you playing. So this is a great thing about it, that improvisation is all about you.
Mira, yo lo que descubrí ahí es la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería. Cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien. Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.